Good morning, everyone. My name is Sheetal. I'm from Dhyeya Career Mentors. A very warm welcome again to all of you in the webinar. Hope you're enjoying the scene. I would like to invite today's guest speaker, Mrs. Geeta Desai, who is the technology head at WMA Banking India. Despite being an extremely busy working professional for more than 20 years, Mrs. Desai is procuring a Master's of Science in Machine Learning. She is an inspiration and truly lives up to the name of Supermom. She will be expressing her views about her journey and how she plans to reach even higher heights in the future. So we have with us Mrs. Geeta Desai as the head of technology in the banking industry. So ma'am, please accept my greetings.
Thank you so much for the introduction and good morning everyone.
So I have questions for you. So the first question is, what factors influenced your decision to work in the IT and banking industries?
Okay, in the IT industry, I was basically introduced during my engineering itself, and we got to do programming. I figured out that that's the field I want to be in. And banking is especially, it's a lot of math which is there. And eventually I figured out, I worked for a networking companies for a long, and then I figured out that my passion lies in data. And that's where I started going towards banking. And because of data, now I'm into data science, moving towards data science.
Great, great. Thank you. Thank you so much, ma'am. So moving on to the next question. Your Adore Marathons, what motivated you to start running?
Running is like, there's a little story around why I chose running. My mom put me into dancing a long time back when I was in third or fourth. I really did not enjoy dancing at all. And outside the window, if I could see, there was a scouts group, which used to practice running. And I enjoyed it. I used to bunk these dancing classes and join those running classes. From there on, I picked it up very, very well. And I went all the way up to district level and then dropped it because of engineering. And then now, I'm back into marathons.
That's really nice. So the next question I'm going to ask is, how do you keep track of your training routine to improve your strength and endurance?
On the physical fitness, we have to do a lot because of the hectic schedules we tend to ignore, and I also tend to ignore it in last COVID things, and I lost all the stamina and I couldn't do much in the last 2 years. Now I have joined back Healthify and I have a coach now who's rigorously training me now, and I'm back with the fitness. So it's always about, we have to keep in mind whatever we achieve, health is the highest importance to us.
So, moving on to the next question. When you are not actively strategizing IT, you also said that studying and implementing are your passions. What are your interest areas where you love spending your time when not working?
Even if I'm not working, most of the times I keep reading on technologies itself. That's a very passionate thing for me. And how new things can we apply across, you know, somewhere in between, I was also interested in writing an app for making our housemates, booking them and getting, because of Corona, we had a lot of these problems. We couldn't get the maids. And so somewhere, everything related to simplifying the life of everyone with technology, that's my passion.
Great. Okay, the last question which I'm going to ask is, if you could give us a few pointers on how to manage work and life balance, that would be really great for us.
This is very, very hard question. I would say, like, in this COVID scenario, it has become even more difficult to differentiate between the work and life. There's no barrier at all. But at some point of time, I think we have to stay, put a strict line right now in this year. It's my resolution for this year itself. Strictly at 10, I just switch off whatever it is at the office. Just do it. whoever is going to call you, then you pick up the call, but don't stay online. We have to put this very, very hard and fast rules on ourselves, and our mindset has to be trained in that way. Because next day you have to again go with the same energy, otherwise we won't be with the energy. That's what I would say.
Thank you. Thank you so much, ma'am. Hope all the moms also got some good insight from you. Thank you. Thank you so much again.
Okay. Now I'm going to take on some questions which are very, very different. Okay. See, we have seen the professional side of yours. That is because when we interacted, you said you are a specialist in chaos engineering. I did a lot of research on that. And I found that in the world, there are not more than 25 people who are experts in this. And you are one of them. And I'm really honored to have you here. Okay. And that's what is very, very important to me. Now, I wanted to ask you this. This is fine. This is like a, you know, completely, I would say, very niche field which you got into. Okay, now, how did you make it to that place? That's more important for me. Because, see, if you look at the entire population of this IT, there are too many people around.
Correct.
So, specialists. So, I want you to take on that.
Yeah. Recently, when I joined this UBS, I joined a year back. Most of the bank's softwares are written long, long back, 20, 30 years back. One way to get out into the newer technologies and make them resilient. We have a lot of security threats. We have a lot of the viruses coming nowadays, and which will break the systems, right? Hackers are there. If our softwares have to be resilient to those kind of hacker attacks and everything, we have to either rewrite all of them, or we have to do something which makes us bring that confidence in our systems. So when I looked into the huge volume of the code that we have and the products that we have, it's almost impossible to rewrite all of them. So I started finding out how do I make our systems resilient. I found out this chaos engineering can help us build that and started implementing it. It was not allowed to build inside the bank itself. Whole of it I built outside the bank. Then once people got convinced, okay, this is the field which we should invest, they took it back into the bank, and now we see a whole lot of stream got set up inside our company itself. It's an effective way of solving the problem for legacy banking applications, products, I would say.
And that's really fantastic, because that's something which is, that is, you're actually directly adding value in terms of a lot of things, you know, in one particular specialization you get into it. Okay, because see, most of the people stay in where they are. You looked at the future, and that's really, really commendable if you look at it. Now, I'll tell you something. To get into something like this and solve some big problems, you need to be very peaceful from within. And that's what I believe. Where do you find peace?
Again, that's a very difficult question to answer. But the peace for me is understanding how to solve the problems we have in a very effective way. My happiness is always in understanding what is there in the newer way of solving the old problems. These are old problems. Everyone can write a new software, right, in a very effective way. There are technologies which can be written, right? But these softwares which are written for 30, 40 years back, how do we solve these problems? That's why I'm with banking. Banks have written their software some 30 or 40 years back, and it's very difficult for them to compete with the new financial products which are coming. How can we do that? That's a problem statement. And that's a problem statement, we have to understand what technologies are there and how do we solve them effectively. So being at peace is like getting those solutions up and running and making people realize what we can do in a newer way. That's my way of looking at things.
Absolutely. That's maybe the meditation for you. Solving the problem itself is that giving that inner self of feeling good about what you did in life.
Yes. Okay.
Another question which I wanted to pose, you know, see that these are all these professional, beautiful life, okay? And there is also a life of a mother.
Correct.
Okay, now what happens is we understand that, you know, during this entire chaotic time which is going on all the time, okay, you also have to look at a few other aspects of maybe the health, nutrition, diet, everything about the kids. Now, that's where the work balance question came in from, Sheetal. What is more important is, how do you prioritize? Because when Indira Nui was asked, what is your priority? She said, my family is a priority. Okay, then the company comes in. What about you?
Same. I think family is the priority and kids are priority. And I definitely make sure that I cook by myself. By no means I want to ever hire any cook. Because nutritious food and food which is liked by family is should be given. We should have it, right? That's the basic priority for me. So whatever it is, however busy, just prepare food, make sure we are following up with our kids. And I also say that because of the generation gap and the technologies, it's a very, very hard thing to cope up with your kids. And I do come to there, you know that how much struggling in that area as well.
Yes.
So it keeps happening. It's all about giving more and more time to our family, I think.
So this is a natural thing with a mother. She's a natural giver. Okay, yes. I know my mother. I said, she wakes up even before it. My son comes at 1:30 at night and she wakes up and cooks for him. Because he's like, okay, he's come back, he's hungry, so I'll cook. Now, of course, fathers cannot understand this, very frankly. But it's really, really, very good thing that the mother is a natural giver. And that's truly what makes you a good professional as well, you know. Like, that's something which is... And the last question which I want to ask, which is the, where you've been in your childhood, okay? Were you the same kind of a person from your childhood till now? Always into the achieving mode or problem solving mode or the creative mode?
Correct. I would say I was always in this mode, right from the my childhood when we had to pull some water from well and we had a lot of water problem in the state, the city where we used to live. And my brother used to find different ways of getting that fast so that we can get time to play. You know, so the same thing continues and we continue to solve the problems. And that's what I enjoy the most. You know? For many, many people and for many, many companies, we should solve the problem, not for just a smaller area.
You said about something about the well part of it, you know, the water well. So where were you in your childhood?
I was in, if you know, Gadag, that's a...
Yeah, we know Gadag, yes.
A lot of water problem there. And we find out what is the which well has got a, more water so that we can pull it easily, or where are less people, and how do we get the rope, which kind of rope, and what should be the length. I and my brother, we did a lot of experimentation with this, so we can save some time.
It's really awesome to hear that. Okay, but then that quality that were built right from the childhood, okay, is what has brought you here. Did you ever imagine that you will be at a level which you are that heading technology for a very core banking kind of a software technology company?
No, I don't think I ever visualized. But the way my parents brought me up and or even my brother, like, every week, my father wouldn't stay, was not staying with us, and he was in another city. The week he comes back, the first question he would ask is, like, what are the challenges you solved? And if you have not solved anything, then he would say, like, maybe you should push yourself to the next level. That's the mindset that he has brought in us, right? So that mindset would make us grow well or make us problem solvers in any industry we have chosen. At least I think I was very sure that we will achieve something with this kind of mindset that our parents brought in.
Beautiful. Because that's one tip which I would like all the super moms to carry it with them. That whenever you're talking to your kids, the first thing you should ask is, okay, what are the problems you have solved? Because the future is about those people who can actually solve this problem. Okay. So thank you, Geeta ma'am. Thank you for giving your time. It is really appreciated and I'm really truly honored to have you on our Super Mom Club. Okay. Of course, there's a long way to go when it comes to Manas. We could work together for it.
Subscribe and press the bell icon to enjoy more exciting and enlightening videos from here.